From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 NOW update.
You are watching News 8 NOW. I'm Tama Ponton. Maine State Police say a Brunswick woman was killed last night after she was hit by a pickup truck in Bodenham. Police say 58-year-old Helen Caloris was looking for a nearby home, parked her car on the side of the road, and got out to cross the street. That's when she was hit by a truck driven by Lisa Green, who lived nearby. Police say Green stopped and found Caloris on the side of the road. Police say Caloris was wearing dark clothing and no charges will be filed against Green. A manhunt will resume this morning for this man, 33-year-old David Hobson. He escaped from the Carroll County House of Corrections in Ossipee, New Hampshire yesterday afternoon. Maine State Police and the York County Sheriff's Department are helping with the search for Hobson, who is from Alfred. Investigators believe he may return to Maine. Police say he was outside in the recreation yard when he climbed over a perimeter fence with razor wire on it. Hobson was in custody awaiting trial for a burglary charge. Searchers are focusing on a wooded area where they believe he may be hiding. Anyone who sees Hobson or has information on his location should call the police immediately. A bench trial is scheduled to begin this morning in a Cumberland County courtroom for Stephen Ricci. Back in August, Ricci pleaded not guilty to an indecency charge. Police say that earlier that month, Ricci exposed himself to a woman. It happened on Stroudwater footpath on Outer Congress Street. In 2006, he faced a charge of attempting sexual abuse of a minor after police say he tried to lure a teenage girl into his vehicle to have sex. In the past, police say Ricci told them he wanted to kidnap, rape, and sexually mutilate a woman. And a man arrested earlier this week in the Oxford County town of Woodstock is expected to be in court this morning. Police say 20-year-old Joseph Cox assaulted a family member and threatened another person before running away. Police believe Cox was armed, and about 50 members of the Maine State Police, its tactical team, the Sheriff's Department, and the Maine Warden Service all search for Cox. Police say they located him at 1000 Main Street in Woodstock around 3:30 Tuesday afternoon, along with a female accomplice. In Portland, Occupy Maine's encampment in Lincoln Park could be coming to an end soon. The Portland Public Safety Committee decided to reject the group's permit application to remain in the park. Now, under city code, no one is allowed to camp overnight in city parks. Occupy Maine asked the city to create a zone in Lincoln Park, which would allow them to stay there 24/7. Two dozen people spoke at last night's public hearing regarding the permit, but the Public Safety Committee unanimously declined the request.
This is very serious public safety challenges that have been ongoing without positive resolution down there. The other is the issue of public access to a public park. We've never given a group a monopoly on public space.
It's the only way to address public safety, and it wasn't a very unreasonable request, is that this be put under a lawful written permit with certain terms and conditions acceptable to the city that would allow both sides to better assure public safety in the park.
The safety committee vote last night was just a recommendation. The permit application will go before the full city council Wednesday. Well, thank you for tuning in to this News 8 NOW update. I'm Tama Ponton. Stay with us and we'll bring you the latest forecast and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.